Hello, darlings. You've all heard of Marilyn Monroe. Some of you know Bridget Bardot. Well, now it's time for the Cognac Show. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh, ooh. I'm a bubbly blonde, fabulously dressed to impress.
This film, The Loving Story, what inspired you to create this film?
It's a story of an interracial couple who married in the late 50s and were arrested for anti-miscegenation or interracial marriage. It was a crime in those days in Virginia and in 20 other states in the country. And they were thrown into jail, exiled from the state of Virginia for 25 years, ultimately took their case to the Supreme Court and overturned all the anti-miscegenation statutes in the country.
Interesting. What made you take on such a film?
I just felt it was a story that needed to be told. I read Mildred Loving's obit in May of 2008 and realized that story had not been told in documentary, and I thought it was time it was.
Let me ask you, is this your first film? Have you done others? It really is your first film.
It's my first directing film. I've produced with other partners a couple of other films, but this is my first directorial film.
And what about here in the Hamptons? Is this your first experience here in the Hamptons?
I've actually been to the Hamptons. I've actually been to the Hamptons previously. I've moderated a couple of panels. I used to run a film festival, so I'm familiar with the Hamptons staff and the founder of the festival. And so I've participated as a juror and a moderator of panels. So, I love it.
Tell my audience, where can we go to find out more information about the film? What's the website?
Okay, the website is lovingfilm.com. We have a Facebook page, The Loving Story, and it will be on HBO in February on Valentine's Day.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And we'll be back in a moment, darlings, for our interviews right here at the Hamptons Film Festival.
Anna?
Jacob, hi.
Let's go. Where do you want to go?
Tell me everything that happened. Tell me everything you saw.
They had lights inside their eyes. They had lights inside their eyes.
Did you see the closing?
What are we going to do after we graduate?
Think about it.
They were kids that I once knew. They were kids that I once knew.
I'm gonna stay.
You can't do that.
Why?
Your visa. Okay.
This is what's gonna happen. You will be placed on the plane immediately and returned back to the UK.
Hi, Jacob. I'm sorry I missed your call again.
Maybe we can try tomorrow. Let me know when it's good for you to talk.
Why?
I wanted to know how my new junior editor was doing.
My new...
Hello?
Hey.
Just give me a couple days, I'll get there, okay?
Okay.
Unfortunately, I can't lift the ban. I'm sorry.
This doesn't feel like I'm a part of your life. I feel like I'm on vacation.
It's hard to keep stopping and starting.
So won't you please just take my hand and take
I thought I understood it.
My whole life.
But I didn't. Only the smudgeness of it. The eagerness of it. The idea of it. Of you and me.
You.
tall.
I love your outfit.
And I love your outfit. Angel, we all know who you are. You're both involved in the film Like Crazy. Well, introduce yourself to the camera.
I'm Drake Doremus, director of Like Crazy.
And I'm Sasha Kozlov.
He's in the new movie which we made this past summer.
Gorgeous, yeah. Gorgeous. Tell my audience about this extraordinary film.
Well, it's a really authentic, genuine look at a romance between two people in their 19 to 27. So it's sort of a first love story.
First love story. Now, tell my audience your influence in the film.
Well, she's not involved.
I had none.
She's just hanging out.
She's just hanging out with you.
Lovely, hanging out.
Well, you are telling him. You're helping him behind the scenes.
Yes, helping me figure everything out. Yes.
Right. Helping him behind the scenes.
Yeah.
Is this your first film? Have you done others?
This is my third. The first two no one really saw. This is getting a pretty wide release and by Paramount at the end of the month, and it's a really special time and exciting time. So
it's getting better and better for you now.
Every year we're trying to get better and better. We're trying to push the envelope and do special things.
Next time I'm going to see you at the Academy Awards, right?
Exactly. I just made my new movie in Long Island. I love Long Island.
LongIslandExchange.com.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
We shot in Oyster Bay and Seacliff. It was fantastic.
Oh, they're beautiful towns. Yeah, absolutely gorgeous.
Absolutely.
Tell my audience, where can we go to find out more about the movie?
You can go to likecrazy.com or you can just Google Like Crazy, and there's tons of ways to get involved in the film on Facebook and Twitter and all those sorts of things.
What are you wearing, darling? Who's the designer?
It's no one. I found it in a little store.
You look gorgeous. Give me a kiss. Good luck. Cheers. And we'll be back in a moment, darling, with more interviews right here at the Hamptons Film Festival. Big champagne kisses. Introduce yourselves to the camera.
Hi, I'm Andrew Moscato. I'm executive producer of Pelotero.
I'm John Paley. I'm a co-director of Pelotero.
Doug Lorenz, executive producer of Pelotero.
I'm Bobby Valentine. I hang around with the celebrities, and it's really fun to be here, but I'm a CP with the company also.
And you're loving the Hamptons. I just heard you love the movies, you love the parties, you love the celebrities, right?
It's a beautiful day today.
It's gorgeous, right?
That's right.
We love the weather today.
Well, last night I saw the big rainbow, and I said, that's good luck. Did you see that rainbow?
Double rainbow we had.
Double?
It was over you.
I saw it, too.
Shining brightly upon you. You look beautiful.
My hair was reflecting it.
It was not one of the colors we featured in the rainbow. But all the other colors were featured. Okay.
So, guys, tell me about this movie. Who's going to talk to me about the movie?
Well, the movie's about two 16-year-old Dominican baseball players, or peloteros in Spanish, who have a short period of time to try and sign a professional contract and change their lives and the lives of their families.
Interesting. Now, what made you want to make a film like this?
Well, I was an Orioles fan, and there's not much looking forward to as an Orioles fan, so I started following the minor leagues and saw a lot more and more Dominican players coming up and wanted to know how they get from these kids on the street with a stick and a rolled-up sock to these major league stars like, you know, Big Poppy and David and Vlad Guerrero and stuff.
Wonderful. If we want to find out more information about the movie, where can we go on the internet?
You can check out the Facebook page, facebook.com/Pelotero Movie.
Spell it.
PELOTERO MOVIE. Or the website is peloterothemovie.com.
Now, when is it going to be theatrically released?
Well, the goal is to find a distributor here at the festival. So besides partying, we're also here looking for buyers of the film.
We forgot about that. That was another piece of why we're here on the Hamptons. There's a little business, but that's going to be after the pleasure. You know, our world premiere is in about an hour, and we are psyched.
Well, good luck, darlings. Good luck right here in the Hamptons. And we'll be back in a moment with more interviews, more celebrities, and more stars.
Absolutely.
lot of service. We are a wait staffing company. We do a lot of work in the Hamptons, a lot of celebrity events. We supply butlers, bartenders, servers, waiters, captains, cooks, grillers.
I love it.
Whatever you need. PlatterServiceInc.com or call 631-589-6999.
Hello, darlings. Welcome back. I'm here with Stuart Suna, who is the founder of this wonderful Hamptons International Film Festival. Now, you founded this so many years ago. How many years ago did you found this?
I didn't found this by myself. We had a board of directors. It was 20 years ago. This is our 19th film festival. Also with people like Toni Ross and her late husband, Jeff Salloway, Stephen Gaines, Joe Zickerman, lots of local people out here who are connected to the film industry. We founded this together.
So you've had, how many movies have actually shown here at the Hamptons Film Festival?
Well, we show anywhere from 60 to 70 feature-length films every year. So you can do the math. I mean, 19 times that. That's a lot.
That's a long time. Out of all those years, was there any movie that showed here that really, you know, showed your interest so much that you said, this is an amazing film? Do you have a favorite?
Well, there's been a lot of, but certainly an easy one is Slumdog Millionaire, which had a quiet launch through the festival circuit. We were here as a, I don't know if we were the North American or New York premiere, but it was really brilliant. Obviously went on to win 8 Academy Awards, and no one had any idea that it was going to be so powerful.
And it won the Academy Awards, it won the Oscar. Interesting, very interesting. Tell my audience, if you want to find out more information about the Hamptons International Film Festival, where can we go on the internet?
Well, hamptonfest.org is our...
Welcome back. I'm Cognac Wellerlane, and we are here at the Hamptons Film Festival. We're here at Nick and Tony's, and we're here with one of the important sponsors of the Hamptons Film Festival. Her name is Maria Dempsey, and she works. She's a rep. It's all about public relations, and it's all about Clarins, the wonderful skincare product line, right?
Yes, it is. Clarins is an international skincare and makeup brand, and we were founded in Paris over 50 years ago, and we've decided to sponsor the Hamptons Film Festival this year to support Lauren Bush and her Million Meal campaign for the Feed organization. So tonight we're giving out these feed bags, which will feed 25 meals for children in need.
And that's so wonderful. Yeah. Now, who came up with this campaign and why do it here at the Hamptons International Film Festival?
Well, Lauren Bush came up with the Feed campaign, and we partnered with her. We're the exclusive skincare and beauty company in the United States, so we partnered with her because there's over 350 million children that go hungry every day. And so we decided to do it here at the film festival because there's a lot of influential people out here, and it's really a good platform to showcase the Clarins brand and also the Feed initiative.
That's wonderful. It really is truly very wonderful that you are doing this.
Yeah.
It really is.
It's great.
I want you to tell my audience, where can we go to find out more information, how we can participate, how we can donate, and how we can contribute?
Well, you can go to Clarins.com or feed.org. You can also buy these feed bags at Bloomingdale's right now, or you can go to Nordstrom.com and buy other smaller little feed bags.
Excellent. Thank you so much,
Ms.
Dempsey, for a wonderful interview. I appreciate that very much.
Nice meeting you. Thank you so much.
And we will be back in a moment, darlings, with more interviews, more celebrities, right here at the International Hamptons Film Festival. Keep watching. Pink Champagne Kisses.
Fantasy dress to impress. One of a kind girl.
This has been a Crybaby Productions, darlings.